I would want to be a scientist who examines type of bones.
I would be an archaeologist, something like that.
I would be a person who would identify things.
A scientist does, it identifies and knows stuff that people don't know, and they tell the whole world, like it spreads and then everybody knows.
Crossroads has a long tradition of community service obligations for students. We felt that as an institution, we also ought to be doing something, and so we created the Crossroads Community Outreach Foundation.
Right from first grade, science has always been a gradable subject on a Catholic school's report card. In many public schools, it kind of takes a back seat because it doesn't become testable until the fourth grade.
One of the strong predictors of whether or not, say, middle schoolers end up going through and getting degrees in science is their interest, is their expectations.
We are putting together a sequential skill building, hands-on curriculum that we hope will serve early elementary kids in public schools.
The beauty of this program is that right from first grade in the primary classes, the children get a hands-on science experience, and that makes a huge difference when they come to junior high school.
I learned about like sound waves.
I've learned like different kinds of animals.
And we saw them turn into moths and lay eggs.
And we mix colors and see what color it would make.
One time we made like this like thing to see how many million years the ice age has been.
And plants and other kinds of natural resources.
Animals live in habitats and adapt to habitats.
I've learned about owl pellets that are like kind of like hairballs from cats.
It's sort of fun discovering bones that you've never seen before.
When they come to do the PS Science program, that it opens science up for them. I think science is very closed off to them before this program, that they begin the exploration of science. And that's what I think that they'll take with them. They'll take it with them into junior high, and they'll take it beyond junior high into high school and into college.
So it's not just a matter that they're playing with stuff, but it's important that they be given the opportunity to ask questions, that they be given the opportunity to try some different things.
What I see that I find very exciting is the way that they are acting as scientists in a community of sharing information and being excited for one another.
You can tell students about, you know, how an owl digests its food, or you can let them sort of understand the process by looking at an owl pellet.
PS Science has impacted my class a lot because there's a lot more hands-on experience. And the kids are passionate about science now.
Living things, the environment, the soil, the mountains, whatever we're talking about, everything works together. And they're starting to see that. It's not yet complete, but they're beginning to see that it's all working together in one piece.
My favorite experiment was when we got water and food coloring, and then we put celery in there and the celery changed colors.
My favorite experiment was when we identified the bones.
My favorite experiment is about how to make a model of a volcano erupt.
My favorite experiment was watching silkworms turn into moths and to see their cocoons.
My favorite experiment was when I put Mentos in a soda bottle.
Probably today, dissecting an owl pellet.
It was like a volcano, except the water came like up and it would be almost as big as that tree.
My favorite experiment is the pellets about the barn owls. It tells me that there was a lot of different animals in the pellet. It's very gross, but it's fun.
I think another benefit of this program is that we're forming global citizens. The children are much more aware of their environment than they were when they started the program. We're preparing them for careers in science. We're preparing them to have greater scientific knowledge that they'll take with them through their whole life.
If you think about it, in the coming decades, these kids, these adults, future adults, are going to be facing a lot of issues that are going to be science related, they're going to be technology related, environment related. And so whether they're voters or, you know, scientists or decision makers in some way, shape or form, they need to have that ability to think and make these sorts of decisions based on understanding, not based on guessing, not based on misconceptions.
These kids need to know what living things do, what living things need. They need to understand it. They need to feel it in their hearts and care about it. And I think giving them these experiences and letting them use their hands, use their eyes, use their senses at this early age is exciting them to care for and be curious about the world.
We're trying to provide a mobile, deliverable, hands-on, experience-based science program for kids that we can take into public schools, where our teachers can work collaboratively with the classroom teacher and develop a program that will really serve the kids so that when they get to fourth grade, where testing actually does begin under the No Child Left Behind structure, they will not be 3 years behind and having to try to jump to a fourth grade level from zero, essentially.
I like to have the science teacher over because science is a lot of fun.
I like science and it's really fun to do.
I love learning about it.
I don't really think I've had a best day because every day for me is just, every day is my best day, so it's, I always like it.
It's today. So my best day was today.
I love science. It's the best thing, probably the best subject ever, and I never want it to end.
Science rules. This is what we dream about. But the only question with me now is do I